Hey art lovers, are you frustrated because you are trying your best in drawings, portraits, but sometimes your nose doesn't look good, sometimes hairs, sometimes whole face looks totally different from reference picture you have? In this video, I am going to talk about how you can do a portrait drawing in easy and effective way. So let's dive into it. Hey, what's up art lovers, it's Shwet, you can call me SP. Welcome to my amazing art channel. In this channel, I upload how to draw portraits drawings. If you are new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and don't forget to press that bell icon. So in today's video, I'm going to draw famous actress Lisa Vicari. You know her by an incredible time machine and time travel series Dark. I have made outlines of this reference pic earlier, so if you want to know how to make outlines perfectly, comment down, I will make separate video for it. Number one mistake people do while drawing a portrait is that they don't make perfect outlines of the face. Their shading is good, their blending is good, but in face measurements, sometimes one eye is bigger than other, sometimes face look bigger than other side. Or from similar mistakes, so many things changes while drawing a portrait. Consider using grid methods for perfect outlines of face. If you want to know how to do a grid method, comment down so I'll make a separate video for that. I always start my sketches from hairs. And number one reason while drawing portraits is that pencil always leaves its dust on drawing surfaces, and while drawing, your palm of course absorbs that dust and your whole white drawing sheet will look like thumbprints. Okay, it's not a rule to start from hairs, but you can avoid that dust particles and thumbprints on your surfaces if you will start from hairs. If you want a separate video for how to draw hairs, comment down below, I will for sure make it. I use charcoal and graphite pencils up to 6B for my each and every sketches and greater outcomes. If you want to buy which pencils I use, you can find it in my description of this video. I have used hard charcoal plus 6B graphite pencils in hairs. While shading hairs, your first focus should be on where your reference pic's hair flow is. If you will do opposite strokes in hairs, it will look too dull. Continuously watch your reference pic's for where the darker portions are and where the lighter portions are. I have used charcoal pencils for darker areas and lighter graphite pencils up to 6B for lighter areas. Look at that strokes, down strokes. Those are perfect and with flow. After completing hair strokes, I am using graphite pencils for her forehead shading. I am using two light shades for it so that it doesn't look too harsh on face. My pencil grip while sketching forehead and faces is too soft, and the only reason is that if you are going too harsh on faces, you cannot rub on highlights and shadows after that. So use soft and easy way for shading faces, forehead and nose, etc. I am using blender stumps for forehead and hairs connection. If you want to buy which blending stumps I use, you can find it in my description of this video. As it was with pencils, I'm still using soft grip for blending stumps. Blending stump will help in creating a realistic look in your face, and your shades of this pencil creating a good quality of shading. You can use earbuds too, but blending stumps are really good for shading and creating a realistic look. Keep focusing on your reference pic. It will help in your shading, your shadows and highlights. If you see so much of harness in your head or any shading, you can remove it by eraser. Always go step by step, using soft hands for pencil, and for blending you can go little bit hard for your shadows. Going too hard will perfectly destroy your picture, like that square in her forehead. I am using charcoal pencils for her eyebrows and her eyes. For eyebrows, just stroke down a little bit harsh while doing charcoal, because charcoal exactly look like graphite pencil if you don't do a little bit hard in your grip. For eyes, just focus on reference pic. You can see that her cornea, a little bit of white always there. Try focusing on details in your reference pic while drawing eyes, because it can perfectly destroy your portrait sketch if you don't do it correctly. You can see that I am drawing outlines first. You can do shades and little bit of details also if you want to do. There's no rule for shading and highlights in drawing. While doing eyebrows, the same rule applies as it was with hairs. You can go with the flow, otherwise your shadows and your eyebrows will look too dull. Use same steps as we used on left eye for right eye. If you want to know a complete tutorial for eyes, how to draw eyes, you can comment down below. I will make that video for sure for you all. As you can see that I have just made outlines and I am not blending it right now, because blending it will create delusion effect and it will destroy outlines and shadows outside it. Use sharpened pencils for eyes, eyebrows, cornea, eyelashes, etc. It will help in creating so many of details, and detail for portrait is everything. Now I am just focusing on little bit of details and shadings upside of eyes and little bit of nose. Always focus on details and shadows and highlights on your picture. Shadowing roughly will create too dull picture for your portrait. As you can see, I am just focusing on details and shadows around eyes. I am not focusing on highlights right now. There is lot of details and shadows under the eyes. I am just focusing on that and using soft pencil, I am just creating and shadowing around it. On the left eye, I am just shadowing little bit part of cornea, and under the eye, same using as I have used in right eye. Now I am focusing on nose. I am just a little bit of outlining the nose and outlining the face. I am rubbing little bit of shadows I have seen in forehead of reference pic. I left a little bit of hairs on the left portion of the reference pic, because if I will complete it in first position, it will create thumbprints, as I said earlier. You can use charcoal and graphite pencils, blending it, and it will create illusion in hairs. Use rubbers wherever you feel you have highlighted or you have left shadows. Now, as you can see, I am just blending what I have shaded with pencils, graphite pencils earlier. You can see that little bit of blending create too good illusion in paintings, and you can use blending stumps for that. Remove extra shading if you think that highlighted or shadow part is uneven. If you see that little bit of details are missing, you can again use it. Always use charcoal pencil for eyes. I am again using blending stubs and watching out shadows for that. What I love about blending stumps that I use, that they come with little bit of varieties. As you can see, I have so much of varieties of blending stumps. These are small stumps, I have used darker stumps, I have medium stumps, so that you can use blending in eyes also. You can't use harder blending stumps in eyes. Now I'm just focusing on nose. I am using graphite pencil for that, and reason is that shading and in reference pic I don't see darker portion in nose. So many pics have darker portion in nose also. Nose creates darker portions around it and below it also. As you can see, while I'm sketching, it looks too bad. But after I will sketch and blend it, you can see that difference I was talking about. As I'm sketching, you can see that I'm just using soft hands for that. And reason behind it is that lighting shadows coming from right hand side of it. Now I am focusing on lips of the reference pic. I have seen that only middle part of the lip is harder, or you can say that it's hard in shadows. I have just used graphite pencil, not charcoal pencil, because it looks too hard. I have just little bit of hard portions in middle of the lips and side of the lips. In the down of the lips, I have just outlined it and just shaded upper and little bit of lower part, because in reference picture I have seen that shadow and highlighted portion is too low in lower. Under the lips there's a little bit of portion of dark. Now I'm just focusing on little bit of hairs that are coming on our face. I'm just shading little bit of light portions, because if I will go hard, it will look too bad on face, because in reference pic it doesn't look good. I'm just shading little bit of parts of shadows that are coming on face. Shading a portrait's chin always create a good portrait, because if chin goes out of the size, the photo will look totally bad. Now I'm just blending lips and other areas where I have shaded with pencil. As you can see, after blending, it is creating a realistic look. As you can see, that nose that was looking too bad before, it's looking too good now. Blending stubs come from every sizes. I'm using small size of blending stub. If you want to know how I am using blending stub, you can ask in comment box. I will perfectly do that. I am using soft hands for creating illusions in nose, because soft light is coming from right side in reference pic. So I am just using soft hands for creating blending stumps, and hard for her smile and her cheeks. If you see any highlights in any picture, you can erase with a little bit of small eraser, or you can find a perfect erasers online. Now I am focusing on other parts of the face, like creating an illusion around eyes. As you can see that it was looking too bad before when I was shading with pencil. But as you can see, now I am shading around, it looks too good. Shade her chin areas too, but with soft hands, it will create illusion effect around. Now I am just shading other parts of her face. As you can see that light is coming from right side. So her hairs are little bit of lighter in shading. Watching reference pic, I am just using charcoal pencils for darker areas around. Around her neck, there is a darker portions that will coming in later in this video. I am just highlighting with darker pencils as you I can see. Now for her fingers, I am using charcoal pencils for highlighting the shadows around and using graphite pencils for shading. She is wearing black jacket, or you can say that she is wearing a black sweater around, and shading it will create illusions around it. For shading clothes and other accessories, always focus on where the shading part or highlighted part is. As we know that on the right side of this pitch, or you can say that reference pic, you have light of source. I'm just highlighting little bit of black color with charcoal pencils for sweater. Now I'll focus on shading darker areas first, and then I'll use blending stumps. I'm just using little bit of forceful blending stumps, or I can say charcoal pencils, for creating highlights around. You can focus on reference pic for that. You can see details and everything. If you are drawing another, or you can see that any other clothes, always focus on any other details you can see. Details will create realism. As you can see, I am just putting little bit of hard pencil around sweater, because in the picture or reference picture you can see that little bit of hard pencils are used or darker pencils are used on the right side and the left side. I have just focused on darker portions. Now for fingers and thumb, you can blend it around. While shading with pencil, it was looking too bad. Now you can see the magic around, and see that after blending, it's creating a little bit of reality look. Only shade hard portions or highlighted portions. Don't shade everything you see. As we can see in reference pic, only hard portions or highlighted portions are there. As we all know that source of light is from right side, so shading should be on right side also. On the left side, it will create highlights. I have left little bit of white portions. You can go darker also. If you have darker pencils or charcoal, just like that, I am using another charcoal pencil for darker portions, for creating highlights on the left side. Doing a layer of another pencil, it will create, always create realism around. Do two shades, do three shades, or do layers around. As you can see, after doing two times of layers, highlighted portion and darker portions are creating illusion of realism. It's not perfect because I am doing too fast for that. If you want to know how to do clothes, you can ask in comment box. Now I am focusing on parts below chin. There is a little bit of dark portion below chin. So I am just using charcoal pencil for that. But using charcoal pencil, it will create two contrast around face and darker portions. I will prefer charcoal pencils only in hairs and clothes. You can use it for darker portions also. Now I am doing her hairs that was around and on the lighter portions of this area. Keep focusing on hair strokes. with reference pick, you can see that on the right side of the portion of hairs, there is a lot of difference. From upper side, it coming from half of the way, and from lower side, it just creating an illusions. Or there is a mass of hairs around. On the left side of the portions, under the chin, there is a lot of hairs that are just creating a mess around. But on the right, top right of the portions, there little bit of dark portion also, and little bit of hard pencils also. Her left shoulder is also visible in reference pic. I'm just using a hard pencil for that, so that it looks different from hairs. If we want to know how to make perfect hairs, I will make another tutorial for that. If you want to know for more about, you can ask in comment box. Focus on details and hair flow. Hair flow will create and it will be so much of useful for creating a good pic. I am telling hairs and pics, but not sketch, because after sketching a perfect sketch, you can say that it look like a pic also. But hair flow, it's so much of useful. I am just shading and going with reference pic. Now just blend the shaded parts we have used. As you can see that after blending, many of the portions are used, and charcoal pencils, you have to blend it because it looks too bad if you don't blend it. And graphite pencils, you can see there is so many of highlighted portions between hairs. If you want to know how to draw perfect hairs, I will make tutorial too soon. As you can see, after blending, it creating a little bit of illusion effect below it. Highlighted portions and shaded portions always create a perfect sketch. Blending it, it will create and help you make a realistic sketch. Now use rubber for creating highlights under the shadows. You can see that face of the portrait doesn't look good. It looks too dull because not every part of this portion of the face should be shaded. Using rubber, you can create highlights, and highlights will help in creating a realistic portrait. You can see that I am just erasing highlighted portion. Don't just highlight or don't just remove every part of the face, because if you will remove shaded part or shadowed part of the face, it will not create realistic face. It will just create a beginner type of sketch. Now for second layer in hairs, you can use charcoal pencils. Charcoal pencil will create a dark portion or contrast around, and highlighted hairs will come around. Using different layers in hairs is too useful, or you can say that using different layers for hairs and faces will help in creating a realistic sketch. Now I am just highlighting any other darker portions or contrast portions I have left in faces. Using two or three layers, it will always create an illusion or a contrast between highlights and shadows. As you can see that after I have just used second layer for that, hair is looking too good. Now use rubbers for creating highlights. As we know that the power source or light source is coming from right side. So just focusing on highlighted portions with reference pick, it will create a good amount of hairs. Those are not perfect, but in less time you can do little bit of good performance. Use rubbers and blending stumps for creating details around. I'm using small detailing blending stumps for eyes and other things so that it doesn't destroy any other details around. Now I am just blending that black part around the chin and other hair parts that are left behind. Many details and many blending portions are left behind, but if I'll do that, this video will be around 1.5 hours. Thanks for watching.